Hi everyone, this is Veronica and today we are going to talk about a very interesting topic, that is telerobotic surgery, which is a medical breakthrough. And here we are going to talk about medical advances. Okay, so for my video updates you can follow me on Instagram, and for the PDF of this lecture it will be available on my Facebook site. So why telerobotic surgery is a news, we will discuss. So guys, this is a channel StudyIQ. If you're preparing for any government exam, our pen drive courses are also available. For additional information, you can visit our website or you can call on these numbers. So first of all, what is telerobotic surgery? So basically, it permits the surgeon to perform an operation on patient from a remote site. Tele means distance, right? So when you're performing a surgery on a patient from a distance, it would be called telerobotic surgery. Now see, why it is in news? Because world's first telerobotic coronary intervention surgery, that is also known as angioplasty, has been conducted in Ahmedabad Hospital. Dr. Tejas performed this surgery from a distance of about 32 kilometers. So finally, it is a proud moment for us that India became the world's first successful country to perform a successful telerobotic surgery. So it was performed on 5th of December, 4th and 5th of December, and after the first successful attempt, it was performed on 5 patients. So now, before talking about how this surgery took place, we would talk about what is telemedicine. So basically, telemedicine means it is the use of electronic information to communicate technologies to provide and support healthcare when distance separates the participants. So basically, tele is a Greek word which means distance, and medery, it is derived from the whole word is derived from the Greek word, and medery is means to heal. So Time magazine called telemedicine healing by wire. Although initially considered futuristic and experimental, telemedicine is today a reality and has come to stay. So basically, it is overcoming many distance barriers. That means it would be helpful, it is helpful to the people living in rural areas which cannot come over cross geographical barriers to go to big hospitals for their health. Now let's see, what is telerobotic coronary intervention? So this doctor was sitting, Dr. Tejas is the name of the doctor. He chose Akshardham temple to perform this surgery. He was sitting in a cockpit, and there was, at a distance in the hospital, there was a cath lab is your catheterization lab, where the patient was lying, and the distance was 32 kilometers. He used robotic techniques. So the place where he was sitting is known as cockpit. The CM of Gujarat and the priests of the temple were also sitting there. They were watching this surgery on a big screen. So now let's see what he did. There was a patient, there was an old lady of 90 years old whose arteries were blocked around 90%. So what are arteries? You know, we have blood vessels in our body. One is arteries and other is veins. So arteries carry the oxygenated blood to the, it supplies the blood to the organs, and it's carried back to the heart through veins. Now there is a coronary artery in our body which supplies blood to the heart. It is basically coronary, it helps in coronary circulation of our cardiovascular system. Now when there's a blockage, what is done? So you need to listen it carefully. So suppose this is a blood vessel which is supplying blood to our heart. Now there is a blockage here, maybe because of some cholesterol plaques, and it cannot supply blood to the heart properly. So because of this, minor heart attacks and even cardiac arrest can take place, which would result in the death of a patient. Now we need to remove these plaques. There is the narrowing of the arteries which we need to end up, so for the proper flow of the blood. Now what is done? There is a instrument called catheter. Catheter is basically a thin tube made from medical grade materials. It can be inserted into body cavity, duct or vessel. So we insert a catheter inside the vessel. This is a deflated balloon catheter, which is later, after inserting it and identifying the block through the help of a fluoroscope or X-ray with the help of a certain dye. When the block is identified, we inflate this balloon so that the narrowing of artery is decreased, it is inflated, and the proper blood flow is maintained. So this is the procedure of this surgery, that is known as coronary intervention, and even this is known as telestenting also. Why we call it telestenting? Now there is another instrument, medical device, which is known as stent. Stent, it is made up of metal or plastic tube. So even with this guide wire and catheter, stent, that is a mesh, is also left in the artery also to remove the blockage. So it always lies there in the your artery so that the blood could be pumped easily. So this coronary intervention is also known as telestenting also. So this is what is performed by the doctor sitting at a distance of 32 kilometers. So it also, he also took the help of internet, and the speed of internet was 100 Mbps. And doctor said it could even be performed with the help of 20 Mbps internet speed also. For the safer side, in the cath lab where the patient was lying or undergoing the surgery, there was a team of doctors also, as it was an experimental surgery, but there no such need arose, and this surgery was quite a success. Now see, it is a world first telerobotic operation. Some facts about it. It is performed by Dr. Tejal Patel, sitting at a distance of 32 kilometer, and the surgery lasted about 50 minutes only. Basically, it is a non-surgical procedure, but however, we are calling it a telerobotic operation. This is all what is written here, and the Gujarat Chief Minister was also there. Why he chose Akshardham Temple for it? Because he wanted to create a combination of spirituality and technology together, because he feels that he gets a lot of positivity from this temple. Because it is in current affairs, you should know about Akshardham Temple also, that Swami Narayan Akshardham is India's iconic temple that celebrates ancient art and architecture, culture and spirituality, wisdom and values. Inspired and created by H.H. Pramukh Swami Maharaj in 1992. The cultural complex spread over 23 acres and was built by more than 8 million volunteers, hours of selfless service. So you should know about its location also. It is in Gujarat, right? So what are the benefits of this kind of telerobotic operation? See, due to many cardiovascular diseases like stroke, there are reported around 18 million deaths per year, which could be prevented because they need a medical examination or an operation within 90 minutes or 24 hours. But because of geographical barriers, many patients could not reach to the hospital. So this could be a benefit to them. Now the robotic operation has a potential to contribute largely in cardiovascular medical emergencies. Not only in cardiovascular, there could be many other uses also in other kind of surgeries also. So this technology will ultimately benefit especially to those groups who have geographical barriers and socio-economic status, and they cannot come to big cities for their treatment. Now for the commercializing, see, Dr. Tejal, he took the help of Corindus Vascular Robotics, which was a partner to him in this surgery. It has pioneered the world's first remote telerobotic interventional platform. Now after this successful surgery, they are also proud of it, and they want to commercialize the system and expand its interventional platform to address stroke care and other kind of surgeries also. So I hope now this topic is clear to you. What is telerobotics, telemedicine? If anything is asked in MCQs or mains, you can write about it. So if you have any queries, you can contact me on my social media. Thank you.